North Island.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, not long after a $15 million refit of the ferry, the Queen of Chilliwack, it was sold to a private operator in Fiji, who happens to be a former BC Ferry employee. The Minister of Transportation, who has ultimate responsibility for BC Ferries, has refused to release the sale price of the Queen of Chilliwack, and we can only presume because of his gross embarrassment. The ferry's new owner, however, was very happy to tell the world about the great deal he got. He reports a sale price of less than $2 million. That's 88% below what BC Ferries spent on the refit, and that happened just before the sale. Madam Speaker, through you to the Minister, can he explain the logic behind the expensive publicly funded refit and bargain basement sale?
Minister of Transportation.
Well, thank you very much, Honourable Speaker. Any opportunity that that we have on this side of the House to answer questions about ferry procurement is one heck of an opportunity to remind British Columbians of the incompetence of the members opposite. This is a group that spent almost $500 million on a couple fast ferries that were actually never used in British Columbia, never used here. Honourable Speaker, the member knows well if she actually placed any value in facts that the refit that was mandated for the Queen of Chilliwack was mandated by Transport Canada to extend that vessel's life by a couple of years for service that it provided on Route 40. We made the tough decision to end that route as part of a collection of initiatives to do everything that we can to drive the pressure on fares down at BC Ferries. And guess what, Honourable Speaker? Guess what? Fares are actually tied to inflation, 1.9% per year moving forward, which is about 4 years ahead of schedule. Honourable Speaker, in addition to that, volumes are up at BC Ferries, and government investment continues to be at record levels for BC Ferries.
Member for North Island on a supplemental.
The Minister leaves me almost speechless, really. I mean, quite an extraordinary answer. I think he also forgets that it is 2016, and people are very aware of what has been happening under this government's remit with BC Ferries. They have seen fares skyrocket, and they have seen money going into a vessel for, as the Minister said, the opportunity to extend its life, but instead of extending its life, they sold it. They sold it for $2 million after spending $15 million on it, Madam Speaker. These are the people who are supposed to look after business, Madam Speaker. Ferry users really don't care whether the Minister is responsible or BC Ferries is responsible for this. They know that their lives are getting much more difficult because of the expense of using BC Ferries thanks to foolish decisions like this refit. Selling the Queen of Chilliwack does not make any sense. Selling it for a bargain basement price does not make any sense. It makes a bad situation worse. So again, to the Minister, he still hasn't given an answer to why he spent $15 million on the refit and then simply gave it away at a bargain basement price.
Minister of Transportation.
Well, again, first off, Honourable Speaker, the Queen of the Chilliwack was deemed to be surplus by BC Ferries. And Honourable Speaker, again, if the member actually did her homework, she would know that it would cost between $1.5 to $2 million per year just to maintain a surplus vessel in BC Ferries' fleet. And it actually can cost considerably more than that to decommission a ferry. In this case, BC Ferries put this vessel onto the open market. The open market was a public tendering process. Bids were received, and the market determined fair market value. Honourable Speaker, that contrasts to a fast ferry program that had an original budget of $70 million. $70 million. That budget ballooned to $462 million. Honourable Speaker, the last time the British Columbians saw fast ferries wasn't because they used them. The last time they saw them, those fast ferries were on a barge being shipped off to Abu Dhabi, never to be seen again.